I'm extremely ambitious. I know exactly what I want to achieve for myself, the kind of films I want to do, the kind of people that I want to work with. And that will always be an ongoing process. Since childhood, I've always known what I've wanted to do. Today, I'm living that dream. But I always say, I'm not satisfied. I'm not fully satisfied. And I don't ever want to be. I want that hunger. I want that motivation to keep me going.
As actors, as artists, you're constantly looking for challenges, either in the kind of role that you do or in the kind of movie. Or like even when I did Cocktail, like Cocktail was completely out of my comfort zone. And I think this was the right film for me. I remember being offered, you know, it's public knowledge.
Yeah,
everyone
yeah,
knows
seven.
I was offered Furious 7 and we tried so hard to make that work and it didn't. And today when I look back, you know, a part of me is like, it just wasn't meant to be. And so I always feel like there's always a right time for everything. And I think this was just the right time for it to happen.
Right.
And it was the right kind of challenge and in a right way. I mean, of course, the character's exciting. But I've never done this kind of, I've done an action film before, but I've not done this kind of action before.
Beauty is not makeup. But your personality is. What you radiate, what you feel, what you embrace about yourself, how confident you are about yourself, that is beauty. Whether you choose to enhance that or not, that's a choice. So if you choose to use beauty products, or you choose for yourself to enhance certain features, that's when cosmetics come in. And sort of enhance what you already have. For me, that's what cosmetics are. You know, you have to sort of know who you are. You have to sort of know your flaws and your strengths and your weaknesses and embrace yourself for that and love yourself for that. That's the general philosophy of it. There's the other philosophy of it, which is beauty is also about what you eat. It's how much you sleep. It's what you eat. That's beauty also. And then there's the third aspect of it, which is your skincare and your cosmetics and your hair. So it's all of these things put together. Sometimes you might like what I wear, like today. And sometimes you might not like what I wear. And that's totally okay. I'm not dressing for you, my love. I'm dressing for myself.
And everything that I have today, materially, if that's what we're talking about, is my own. You know, I've earned it. I've started from scratch. I've not borrowed anything from anybody, including my parents. I'm always someone who looks at the brighter side and will always be happy that there's also a large part of people who appreciate it. From being written off 10 years ago to being where I am today, I feel truly, truly blessed in so many ways. But at the same time, I'm not going to say I've been lucky. I've worked very, very hard.
Definitely.
To get to where I am. 2014, post the experience and post coming out with my experience with depression, I also felt like I didn't want to stop there. I felt like I wanted to give back and I wanted to help people. And so for me, coming out and speaking out openly was to sort of help people understand what depression is, because you don't really see very obvious physical signs or symptoms unlike certain other illnesses. And I felt like by coming out and sharing my experience with the world, if I could help even one life, I felt like the purpose would be served. If there's one thing that feels the most rewarding or the one thing that I'm most grateful for is the fact that I've been able to speak out. I think if there's one thing that anxiety and depression has taught me is self-awareness. And while I'd like to believe that I've always been pretty aware of my feelings and emotions, I feel like this experience sort of just amplified that for me. I often feel like, and women especially feel like, when they take care of themselves or take time out for themselves, it often comes with an element of guilt. And I feel like that's the one thing I've stopped doing. I feel like if I want to rest, if I want to massage, if I want to sleep, I've started enjoying those moments without the guilt. And I think self-care is the one thing that has really helped me on this journey, you know, to recovery. You know, it works differently for different people. So I think it's really about listening to yourself and finding your own inner balance.
Through the years, I think the one thing that I've learned is to be patient and to really believe in yourself. I mean, you can have, you know, amazing people around you telling you different things. Some people really believe in your vision and some people won't. Some people will also discourage you and say, you know what, are you sure you want to do this? Are you sure you want to wait? Are you, you know, why don't you try something else or do something else? I think it's important to be, I mean, at least I fortunately had a lot of clarity about what I wanted to do with my life and for myself. And I've been very patient through all of it. And I'm not someone, I don't give up easily. The minute you tell me that I can't do something, I work that much harder to prove, not to people, but to myself, that I can do it. It can be anything.
So I think a lot of people feel like people in the industry are very privileged. But that's not true. There's a lot of hard work and commitment and dedication and sacrifices that go into being who we are or achieving what we do.
I do not want my career to be like anyone else's but my own. Because it's a very, very personal thing, and something that I like, somebody else may not like. So it cannot be, even if I want it to be, it cannot be. And I want to be remembered for my own individual sense of everything, whether it's style, whether it's films, whether it's career graph, whether it's you know, values that you stick by. It has to be your own.
I think you want to keep adding layers to yourself, to your life, to your career. I don't view them as two separate careers anyway. I think that's the biggest mistake people make. I look at it as one long journey with different things that will be thrown at you, different challenges, and how do you make them your own?
What I do what I love. The money happens to come. It means nothing, you know. And I know so many people, and my own experience is, yeah, you can have everything in the world, but if you're not happy, you can do nothing with it, and it really means nothing.
I really don't know what success means to me, but I think for me, to be truly successful is to be at peace with myself and to be happy with every day. I think depression has taught me that. Depression has taught me how fragile my life is, or how fragile our lives are, and it's made me value people and emotions and feelings. And you know, so for me, it's not the material things, it's not the numbers, it's not, because there's always more. You can be number one and then you'll still want to keep going at that, or, you know, you can be, you know, you can have X amount of money and there's no end to that. So as far as material things are concerned, I think there's no end to it. You'll just, you know, people want more and more and more, and that's human nature. But to be truly at peace with yourself, that is success for me.